likes you, motherfucker. Oh yeah, that needs to be locked up. Bitch, I don't have time for that. Sheesh. I am not wasting time like that, no. Why is this notification doing like this? It's weird. Yeah, I'm not wasting time. Sorry, I'm not wasting time. Yeah, you think you can waste my time? No. I don't care about your son. Sheesh. That's all I even care about. I don't care. I don't know if I can care about any of his anything. I just pick him up and dump him off at work. Same thing coming back, just dump him off at home, and that's it. I'm not fucking doing anything else that's unnecessary. Yeah. Unnecessary, I'm not doing it. With 24/7
claim support, it's easy to Geico. Let me finish this song first. The part. Yeah, of course.
Ready to find your funds? Then it's time to finish your FAFSA. Your FAFSA application is the only path to college financial aid, grants, and scholarships. If you want to chase your dreams and accomplish your goals, you've got to find your free money. It's quicker and easier than ever. Your FAFSA gives you the opportunity to keep growing so you can find your focus and your fabulous. Finish your FAFSA, find your future. Start today at finishfafsa.com. Brought to you by the Thurgood Marshall College Fund.
9:10 a.m. KKSF, Oakland, the Black Information Network.
Listen at BINnews.com or tell your smart device to play the Black Information Network on iHeartRadio.
I'm Ree Harris, and here's the latest from the Black Information Network. Today marks the 10th anniversary of the fatal shooting of Michael Brown in Ferguson, Missouri. The 18-year-old unarmed black man was shot 6 times by a Ferguson police officer, leading to protests against police brutality in Ferguson and around the country. Tropical Storm Debbie is not finished yet. Virginia and North Carolina are getting high winds, heavy rain, and possible tornadoes. It will eventually head all the way up the northeast coast this weekend. The storm that originally made its landfall in Florida has already been blamed for at least 7 deaths this week. And forecasters are watching yet another system in the Atlantic. And that's the latest. I'm Ree Harris on your home for 24/7 news. The Black Information Network at BINnews.com.
Tyler.
And I'm Mike Stevens on your home for 24/7 News, the Black Information Network.
A lot more of America is loving Kamala Harris. A new poll showing a shift in independence moving her way.
I am so deeply honored as a lifelong supporter of union labor for Tim and I to have the endorsement of UAW.
Just as she was in Detroit meeting with United Auto Workers, comes the release of a Marist poll. Independent voters going 53 for Harris, 44 for Trump, a 9-point lead, a group that gives a huge advantage, which is why Donald Trump wants not one, but 3 debates. During a Mar-a-Lago news conference, he of course came with the insult.
She's not doing any news conference. You know why she's not doing it? Because she can't do a news conference. She doesn't know how to do a news conference. She's not smart enough to do a news conference.
For now, Harris did agree to a September 10th debate on ABC.
The tables have turned. Large crowds at the Harris Walls rallies are chanting a familiar phrase.
Up, referring to Donald Trump. The Vice President Harris stops them.
The courts are going to handle that part of it. What we're going to do is beat him in November.
As mentioned, Trump did hold a news conference covering familiar themes. Doubts about the election, crisis at the border. But things really went off the rails when reporters asked his thoughts on the Harris Wall crowd size. First, he praised his crowds on January 6th before the Capitol was invaded. He invoked the name of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Nobody's spoken to crowds bigger than me. If you look at Martin Luther King, when he did his speech, his great speech, and you look at ours, the same real estate, same everything, same number of people, if not, we had more.
Checkers say it was another Trump lie, or at least an extreme exaggeration.
Despite the criticism the Trump Vance campaign is using now to slam Team Harris and Walls, a newly released phone recording shows Donald Trump, who was president at the time, praised Minnesota Governor Tim Walz for his handling of the George Floyd protests.
I know Governor Walz is on the phone, and we spoke, and I totally agree with the way he handled it the last couple of days. I asked him to do that. He's on the phone now, Tim Walz, and again, I was very happy with the last couple of days. And he called up big numbers, and the big numbers knocked him out so fast it was like bowling pins.
Riots broke out in the streets of Minneapolis in May of 2020 after Floyd was murdered. Republican VP candidate J.D. Vance criticized Governor Walz, saying he allowed rioters to burn down the streets of Minneapolis. But that phone call recording shows Trump raising how Walz handled things.
I'm Vanessa Tyler with Mike Stevens on your home for 24/7 News, the Black Information Network.
Traffic and weather
on the Bay Area's BIN 910.
In Sunnyvale, here off ramp 85 northbound and Homestead Road, that is shut down while they remove an encampment of unhoused people who were seeking shelter. That's expected to go on until about 4 o'clock. A bus fire blocking your right lane in Pleasanton. 680 northbound before Stone Ridge Drive. You can't get by on the middle lane. A 9-minute backup from Brunel Avenue. And remember, in San Francisco and Golden Gate Park, starting today around noon until 10 p.m. Sunday, the Outside Lands Festival will cause some big crowds and big delays. Use public transit if you can. It's going to affect those surrounding streets in the Richmond and Sunset District. Checking the area weather, lots of sunshine, a little less heat. Our highs climbed to 94 inland, 70 in Oakland, 76 Bayside, 64 in San Francisco, and 60 at the beaches. There is an air quality advisory in effect. With Bay Area traffic and weather, Jackson Summers on the Black Information Network.
America's trusted Black voice.
The Black Information Network.
The Bay Area's BIN 910.
I'm Natasha Williams on your home for 24/7 News from San Francisco's BIN 910. Growing up in Oakland, Ariel Gillum, who is Black, never envisioned a future filled with jewelry and jackets. Instead, her dreams were focused on jerseys and jump shots.
I grew up playing basketball, so basketball is my first love. So I always felt like basketball was going to be like sort of my ticket or way out.
She tells NBC Bay Area her early years were filled with trouble.
My childhood was a rough upbringing, single-parent household. My mom was in an abusive relationship for 17 years, so grew up in that for the whole time.
She says just about the time her professional basketball dreams began to fade, however, a friend asked Gillian to style an outfit for a photo shoot. Though Gillian had always enjoyed fashion, she was voted best dressed in school. She had never considered it a feasible career path until then.
After she got dressed, I was like, wow, I just did what a stylist can do. And I was like, I want to keep doing it, and that's where I pursued it.
Gillian not only pursued styling, but she also excelled at it, working with international fashion brands, athletes, and artists. Grateful for her success in the career she once thought unattainable, Gilliam is now dedicated to inspiring the next generation in Oakland to believe in themselves. About a year ago, Gilliam pivoted her career from styling to teaching fashion enrichment classes to various organizations and nonprofits to young people. She teaches basic of fabric and style, but her goal is to offer something even bigger. She wants her classes to help build confidence, self-esteem, allowing people to learn to love themselves, especially children, and to receive the love from them, she says, because she knows that sometimes at home, the children, the people that she's trying to reach, don't get that kind of love. She says if she can give a person a hug and they can get joy from that, then she feels like she's done her job. In other news, several California lawmakers will head to Chicago to represent the Golden State at the Democratic National Convention later this month. Senate Pro Tem member Mike McGuire confirms 7 state senators will be excused for 48 hours to attend a major event. Assembly Speaker Mike Rivas added the assembly plans to send a small group as well. Governor Gavin Newsom is also expected to attend the convention. State legislative leaders assure business will proceed as usual at the California State Capitol when the convention begins on August 19th as lawmakers sift through hundreds of proposed laws. And efforts to clear homeless encampments in San Francisco are slowing down. A judge found the amount of employee training to be inadequate and wants to know how many workers know what to do. The policy calls for giving people 30 minutes to pack up and leave if they refuse shelter. Those who aren't from the area get a ticket back home. The issue now seems to be how the city handles their belongings on the street. And that's a look at what's going on in the Bay Area. For more on these stories and international, national, state, and local news affecting the Black community, listen to the Black Information Network on the iHeartRadio app or log on to BINnews.com. On social media, you can follow us on X at Black Info Net. I'm Natasha Williams on your home for 24/7 news on San Francisco's BIN 910.
Telling our stories is more important than ever, and the NABJ is committed to training and supporting Black journalists, media professionals, journalism students, and educators. Learn more at NABJ.org. Trusted news 24/7.
The Black Information Network.
The Bay Area's BIN 910. This hour of news is brought to you by Bank of America, proud founding partner of the Black Information Network.
Did you know that your melanin-rich brown skin is a natural wonder? It's our armor against the sun. But even superheroes need protection. Whether you're just outside for brunch with friends or taking a walk around the neighborhood, sunscreen is the best protection. Because it isn't just for the beach. It's an everyday essential. It helps shield your skin from harmful UV rays, preventing signs of premature aging, sunspots, and even skin cancer. Remember, self-care isn't selfish. It's self-love. We all deserve a little self-love, and CVS is your ally in skin health no matter what you're looking for. From moisturizers with SPF to dermatologist-tested skincare, CVS shelves are stocked with a wide range of skincare products, specially curated for diverse needs. From brands like Black Girl Sunscreen to e.l.f. Invisible Sunscreen. So protect your natural glow, celebrate your uniqueness, and let CVS support you on your beautiful skin health journey. Even if you're having skin issues, you can schedule a skin assessment with a MinuteClinic provider. Stop by your local CVS today. Learn more at CVS.com.
Stories about our people.
Congresswoman Cori Bush is the underdog in Tuesday's primary.
By our people.
Freedom Hair tells the inspiring true story of Melanie Armstrong, who fought the Mississippi government to legitimize professional hair braiding.
For all the people.
We get those positive interactions by having officers that know the people in the neighborhood.
The Black Information Network.
The Bay Area's BIN 910 and on the iHeartRadio app.
In the U.S., Black adults experience the effects of heart disease more than any other racial or ethnic group. Merck is researching an investigational medicine to see whether it may help lower the risk of serious heart problems, like heart attack or stroke. The research study is enrolling adults age 18 years or older. Talk to your doctor today and find out if you may be able to join this clinical study. For more details, visit coralreefstudies.com/outcomes. That's CORALREEFSTUDIES.com/OUTCOMES.
Telling our stories is more important than ever, and the NABJ is committed to training and supporting Black journalists, media professionals, journalism students, and educators. Learn more at NABJ.org.
If you've got a story, we want to know about it. Black Information Network hotline at 855-500-9BIN. You've got a voice. We've got a hotline. Call the Black Information Network at 855-500-9BIN.
Network.
The opinions, beliefs, and viewpoints expressed in this commentary are those of the author and do not necessarily represent those of BIN and its founding partners and employees. Now it's time to bring the funk with Roland S. Martin.
Republicans are truly beside themselves. Over what to do with Vice President Kamala Harris and Minnesota Governor Tim Walz.
Jenny Vance, Trump's VP pick, is complaining to the media, why aren't y'all asking her more questions? Why aren't y'all demanding she do interviews? Don't know. It's our town. Check this out. They've been attacking Walls, saying that, he left this enough on his gun. Check this out. The Republicans have been saying Tim Walls was hired from the town.
Her parents did. Original executive producer Debbie Allen and Tom Werner
returning and promised to capture the essence of the original show. And actor Jonathan Majors has requested an extension to respond to the lawsuit filed by his ex-girlfriend, Grace Jabari. According to documents obtained by In Touch, the civil lawsuit, which includes allegations of assault, battery, and defamation, prompted Majors' new legal team to seek more time, extending the deadline from August 15th to September 19th. The extension is needed to gather relevant information and continue discussions between the both parties. Finally, rapper Kodak Black is facing criticism after delivering an anti-drug message to a youth football team in Florida. During his speech, Kodak advised the young athletes to say no to drugs because they're too good, implying that the temptation could lead to addiction. While his intention was to warn the kids about the dangers of drug use, then he found his choice of words problematic and potentially confusing. One ex, critics argued that his message might not effectively convey the serious consequences of drug abuse. However, supporters say they like his straightforward approach and that being politically correct is not important. With the latest in entertainment at 17 and 47 minutes past each hour, I'm Bree Wood on your home for 24/7 News, the Black Information Network, and BINnews.com.
Time now for traffic and weather.
On the Bay Area, BIN 910.
Heading over to Pittsburgh, there is a crash in your Center 5 or westbound before Basin Road. You're jammed 3 minutes from Harbor Street. That's a two-car wreck. Still going on the Bay Bridge, 80 westbound between the Toll Plaza and the metering light. And when you get to San Francisco, there's a one-minute backup. That's a big improvement. 101 northbound between 280 and the hospital curve. Sunnyvale, your 85 northbound off-ramp to Homestead Road shut down while they remove an encampment of unhoused people who are seeking shelter. That should all wrap up around 4 o'clock. Checking Bay Area weather, the inland heat soared to a 94. Yes, we're still in a cool down. Just 70 in Oakland, 64 in San Francisco, 76 Bayside, and 60 at the beaches. Falling tonight to the mid-50s to low 60s. Inland highs will reach the mid-90s Saturday, upper 80s Sunday. With Bay Area traffic and weather, Jackson Stewart on the Black Information Network.
In AI and the barriers that keep Black techies away from being in decision-making positions?
The industry and the technology space as a whole with respect to representation, when we're such a small percentage of the people who build the technology and maintain the technology, it's hard to get our folks advances.